Hey, what's up guys? It's Acid Glow here. Welcome to a video that I'm calling Killer Instinct: What Came True Part 1. This is basically when we look at things that came true after the announcement of Killer Instinct and before it was officially announced. Alright, so first thing on the list, back on May 25th, I made a video called Xbox One Exclusive Killer Instinct. This was before the game was even announced during E3 in June. So back on May 25th, I made that video and I was explaining why I thought Killer Instinct was going to be an Xbox One exclusive. Now, during a press conference, I believe it was Phil Spencer from Microsoft that said that Xbox One was going to have a returning franchise. And from all the news I read over the past year where Microsoft was trying to renew the Killer Instinct trademark, it only made sense that was the returning franchise. And then during E3 on June, guess what came out? Yep, the announcement trailer for Killer Instinct. Alright, so next thing on the list was also during E3. They also had the Jago combo video trailer. Now, within an hour of that one being released, I actually put up my own version of that talking about the combo system and what was going on during all the combos that Jago was doing. And I made a judgment that the combo system felt very similar to Killer Instinct 2, with super linkers, shadow moves, except you had the ability to expand your combo a little bit further than what Killer Instinct 2 had. And later on down the road, we had more videos from Double Helix, and that pretty much confirmed that it was similar to Killer Instinct 2. Alright, so next thing on the list, back on June 16th, I made a video called Top 10 Ideas for Killer Instinct 2013. One of those ideas was we should have lots of colors to choose from. And as the months came by and we saw different builds of Killer Instinct, we actually saw more colors added to the game. So I believe right now we have a total of 6 colors for each character available. And the next one on the list is also from my Top 10 Ideas video. I suggested they should bring back the classic costumes. And shortly after, we actually got news about the pricing for the different packages available for Killer Instinct. And in one of them, guess what we saw? Classic costumes. Alright, and the next one is also from my Top 10 Ideas video. I was looking at a build that was showcasing the shadow moves, and this is around the time when that build only had one shadow behind the character's shadow move. And I was recommending they can actually change it to be more similar to Killer Instinct 2, where when you perform a shadow move, you would have multiple shadow clones behind you, not just one. And during the next build, guess what we saw? We saw multiple shadows behind your character when they performed a shadow move. Alright, so here's another thing from my Top 10 videos that came true. I also mentioned that I'd like to see the classic Killer Instinct arcade games come in a bundle pack. And then around the time when we got the pricing for the different packages, guess what we saw in the Ultra Edition package? We saw Killer Instinct Arcade as part of that bundle pack. Alright, so next one on the list. Back on July 23rd, I made the first Chief Thunder predictions video on YouTube. And right there, I was calling it that he would be the first grappler character. Now, I was making my judgment based on his design from the first game. I felt he was really limited. And so I thought, you know, he would be a good character to be designed as a grappler character in the new Killer Instinct game. And so shortly after, we got the Chief Thunder combo trailer. And guess what, guys? I called it first before anyone else. He ended up being a grappler character. Alright, and the last one on the list is back from August 24th. So I made a video on my theory about Sadeera's fighting style. Now this is exactly the same night when her teaser trailer was released. Now that teaser trailer was not a combo trailer. It was the one that was showcasing different angles of her body. She did one combo and then the video ended. Now, during that video, I was looking at that one combo and it gave away the entire fighting style right there. Because the guys at Double Helix were saying that the next character reveal is going to be someone unexpected. It's going to be someone completely new with a new style. And I figured, well, you guys just gave it away with that teaser, because I was calling it right there. She was going to have air combos. And guess what happened when her combo trailer was released? She had air combos. I did make an Orchid predictions video a long time ago. And in that video, I was comparing her move set from the first Killer Instinct game and the second one. And I was kind of wondering what her changes were between the two games. And I was thinking she might actually be a balanced character like Jago, except with a different move set. So now that Orchid is slightly revealed, I guess in a few weeks' time when we see her combo trailer, we'll find out if I'm right. Alrighty guys, so that is the end of Killer Instinct What Came True Part 1. Now Part 2 is not going to come out until 2014 because we need to give the game some time when it does come out and see what they're going to change and what they're going to add into the game. So to finish off this video, I know a lot of you people doubted me for months about my Killer Instinct knowledge. I don't mean to rub it in, guys, but I was right on many occasions.
Awesome combo!